This video is going to be about multiplying fractions. And this is really pretty straightforward. So let's say I've got these two fractions, 3 over 5 times 2 over 7, and I'm multiplying them. The basic rule for multiplying fractions is that you multiply across. In other words, you multiply the numerator times the numerator, and then you multiply denominator times denominator. So numerator times numerator is 3 times 2. That's going to give me a 6. And for the denominators, I have 5 times 7. So that gives me 35. Then you always want to look and make sure that you can't simplify or reduce it. In this case, I can't. I can't divide 6 and 35 by any numbers that are the same. So that's going to be my answer. Here's another one. Here I've got 3 over 8 times 5 over 3. So I'm going to multiply across. I've got 3 times 5 is 15. And 8 times 3 is 24. And then before I decide that I'm done, I want to see if I can reduce it. And I realize that both 15 and 24 can be divided by 3. So I'll divide them both by 3. And then I get 15 divided by 3 is 5. And 24 divided by 3 is 8. So my answer is 5/8. Now, there's a much faster way to get to this answer. Let's look at the problem again. I've got 3 over 8 times 5 over 3. And looking at this, I realize I've got a 3 in the numerator and a 3 in the denominator. And what I'm going to do is divide this 3 by 3 and divide this 3 by 3. In other words, when I did this the first time, I ended up dividing both the numerator and the denominator by 3. Well, if I divide by 3 as the first step, then my multiplication is much easier. It's just 1 times 5 is 5, and 8 times 1 is 8. And I've saved some steps along the way, and I end up with exactly the same answer. So basically, what you want to do when you start out is look at the original problem. If you see any numbers that are the same in both the numerator and the denominator, you can cross both of those numbers out, just like I did here. Remember, when you cross them out, you get a 1. Don't think that you end up with 0, otherwise we'd have 0 times 5. Sometimes we forget to write the 1 in, but crossing it out still means you're dividing 3 by 3, and you're getting a 1. Okay, here's another problem. So I've got 4 over 6 times 3 over 2, and looking at this, all of my numbers are different, so it seems like I should be able to just do the multiplication. But if you stop a second and think about it, you realize that 4 is the same as 2 times 2. And if I think of 4 as 2 times 2, then I can divide both the numerator and the denominator by 2. So I'm going to cross that 2 out and cross that 2 out. And then looking at the 6, I can think of the 6 as 3 times 2. And now I've got a 3 here and a 3 here, so I'll cross both of those out. And then looking further, I see I've got a 2 and a 2. That's all I've got left for my numerator and denominator. So I'm going to cross those out. Now remember, when I cross these out, there's a 1 somewhere there. So what I'm left with is my numerator consists of nothing but the numbers that I crossed out, and they're really just 1 now. So I've got 1 for my numerator. I've got 1 for my denominator. Any number divided by itself is equal to 1. So my answer is 1. Okay, so once again, before you do your multiplication, what you want to do is see if you can somehow divide something in the numerator and something in the denominator by the same number. It might mean you have to break a number down, like breaking the 4 down into 2 times 2, or breaking the 6 down into 3 times 2. But doing that will make everything a lot faster, a lot easier, and probably less of a chance of making a mistake. Let's look at one more. Okay, so I threw this one in because basically I just wanted to do something with negative numbers. The rules for negative numbers, for multiplying negative numbers, are going to be the same as what they always are. In other words, two negatives multiplied together will make a positive. A negative and a positive multiplied together will make a negative. Okay, so I've got negative 5 over 9 times negative 6 over 7. And I could multiply straight across, but before I do that, I realize that 6 is 2 times 3, and 9 is 3 times 3. So let's get rid of a 3. Now I've got nothing that I can reduce anymore. I've got a 5, a 2, and a 7, and there's no way I can divide a 5 or a 7 or a 2 into something that will help me. So I'm just going to do my multiplication. So I've got negative 5 times negative 2. Negative times negative is positive. So I've got a positive 10. My denominator is 3 times 7. So that's 21. I can't divide 10 and 21 by any number that's the same. So that's going to be my answer. Okay, so this is really pretty simple. I know people are afraid of fractions and they try to avoid them. The more you do them, the easier they get, and the more they just become as easy as other numbers. Okay, that's it for now. I'll see you next time.